Hi, my name is Mike Wolf. I'm a research fellow at the Berkeley Center for Law and Technology. I'm here today with Mike Carroll of American University Law School, and we're talking about addendums that authors can place on their publishing contracts to secure a little bit more rights than they would otherwise normally have. So, Michael, if you could introduce yourself, that would be wonderful.
Okay, great. So, hi, my name is Mike Carroll. I'm by day a law professor at American University Washington College of Law. I'm also on the board of directors of Creative Commons, and I've worked with SPARC, a library advocacy group working on open access issues since 2004. And in that capacity, they asked me if I could draft a standard addendum that could be attached to a publishing agreement that basically changes the terms back in the author's favor.
Great. So when you say addendum, it's sort of a term of art. Yeah. In general, author receives an agreement, they sign it, and that's the end of the story. Right. How does the addendum fit in?
Well, so a licensing agreement, a publishing agreement, is a contract between the author and the publisher, mm-hmm. saying in exchange for my investing in your work and publishing it, you will give me your copyright or some version of your copyright. And in the digital era, it's better to divide up the rights between the publisher and the author so that the publisher gets the rights they need to make it public, but the author retains sufficient rights to post their work online. And the addendum basically says, I understand your publishing agreement wants all the rights, but I think a fairer split is you get to publish, but I get to post. And that's essentially what the addendum says, is I'm changing the terms of your agreement, and if you agree to my change, then we have a deal.
And is this reasonably standard now? Are publishers ready to expect that an author might come back with something that would modify the standard agreement?
It depends on the publisher. There's been a range of experience. Some publishers don't mind and they accept it right away. Other publishers have developed means of trying to categorically reject these by essentially requiring the authors, particularly in the journal context, to give away their copyright when they submit the article for consideration, and therefore not having this chance for the addendum. But what's happened is the friction that the addendum creates on the publisher side causes them to sometimes change their own agreements to be more reasonable. And so we've seen progress in that way, sort of the sand and the oyster kind of thing.
So if I'm an author and I want to go and say I'm unhappy with my current publishing contracts, I would really like to have the right to post my work, to have copies of the final print version that I can share or use. Yeah, where would I go about finding an addendum? Or you referenced the SPARC addendum in particular, which you wrote. And is that available online?
That's available online. In fact, Creative Commons hosts something called the Addendum Author's Addendum Engine, because there are a couple of these standard addenda that do different things. And so if you go to the Creative Commons Addendum Engine, you can sort of pick your battle, if you will. Pick exactly how many rights you want. The most robust is, I don't just want to put it online. I want to give the audience a Creative Commons license. So so there's one addendum that would do that. Another one that just says, you can publish it, but just give me the right to put it up on the web.
So you could almost envision a negotiation with a publisher on finding an addendum that might satisfy everybody to some degree or another.
Right. And so I'm going to use that as the opportunity to address the central thing that bothers me, is that authors somehow feel as if their work has been accepted by the publisher, it's under editorial process, and if I ask for these rights, somehow or another, the publisher is going to walk away and not publish because I had the temerity to ask to negotiate. That doesn't happen. Either they'll say, we're not going to negotiate, or let's negotiate. But they don't just say, the fact that you asked means that now we're not going to publish you because you've been bad. So, you know, timid authors need to step up and be willing to ask for the rights that they think they deserve.
Well, great. Thank you so much for taking the time to talk with us today. Greatly appreciate it.